Hello dear students, welcome back to the class 9. So in the last class we have started with your exercise number 10.4, that is the first question. So before that, first of all I am going to discuss the revision video on class 9 for your upcoming examination of post term, that is PT3. For this purpose I have made one revision video. In that first question I am going to discuss, that is prove that the diagonals of parallelogram divides into two congruent triangles. So see here, prove that, this is from the theorem quadrilaterals. Okay, so prove that the diagonals of parallelogram divides into two congruent triangles. First of all, what you will do, first of all you have to draw the diagram, draw the parallelogram, that is A B C D. Okay, so draw the parallelogram A B C D and draw one diagonal BD. Okay, so this I call this as angle 1, and this I call this as angle 2, and this one I call this as angle 3, and this one I call it as angle 4. Okay, so first thing, a given, in the given I will write this as, in the given the first thing I am write, that is ABCD is a parallelogram. ABCD is a parallelogram. ABCD is a parallelogram. Okay, so first thing given is ABCD is a parallelogram. To prove that, what we have to prove? To prove that triangle ABD is congruent to triangle, that is CDB, that is ABD, triangle ABD is congruent to triangle, that is CBD, triangle CBD. So this we have to prove. Okay, so triangle ABD is congruent to triangle CBD. So proof what we'll write, that is consider the triangles, consider the triangles, which triangles we need to consider, that is triangle ABD and triangle CBD. Okay, so we have to consider the triangles ABD and triangle CBD. Okay, so see, first thing what we can write, angle 1 is equals to angle 2. So first step I can write this as angle 1 is equals to angle 2. Why I will write angle 1 is equal to angle 2? Because these are alternate interior angles. Alternate interior angles. Okay, similarly we can write this as, that is, so second one you can write this as BD is common. So BD is equal to BD. Okay, so this is one common thing. And again alternate interior angles, and also we can write AD is parallel to BC and BD is a transversal. So you also can write alternate interior angles, AD is parallel to BC and what is transversal, that is BD is a transversal, and BD is transversal. Okay, similarly you can write angle 3 is equals to angle 4. Angle 3 is equals to angle 4. So this is also alternate interior angles, and also you can write the same reason, that is AD is parallel to BC and BD is transverse. BD is transverse. Okay, so again we can say this as angle, side angle. Okay, so finally you can write as by ASA, by ASA congruence, that is triangle ABD is congruent to triangle CBD. Okay, again by CPCD, by corresponding parts of congruent triangles, I can write this as, what I can write, that is angle ABD is equal to angle CBD. Hence, prove. Dear students, welcome back to the one more theorem of your revision part. That is, prove equal chords of a circle sustain equal angles at the center. Means what? First of all, before that, what is, you should know what is angle subtended. If I take any line segment AB, and if I take any point outside the line segment, I call this as R, and this join AR and RB. Okay, and this ARB is called as angle subtended. Angle ARB is called angle subtended. Angle subtended. Angle subtended by the line segment. By the line segment, that is AB at R. Okay, so we have to discuss about prove that equal chords of a circle subtend equal angles at the center. Means what? So see here, dear students, what you have to do? We have to draw the circle. First thing, we have to draw the circle. Okay, so let's to take two chords. So first chord I call AB from the center O and join this OA and OB. Similarly, takes one more two chords. That is, I take this as PQ and join POQ. Okay, so this is the diagram of this theorem. Prove that equal chords of a circle subtend equal angles at the center. Means what? Given, what is given? You should write given. First point, let's draw a circle. Let's draw a circle. Okay, second point, okay, draw the two chords. So draw two chords, draw two chords, that is AB and PQ at center, at center O. Okay, so what we have to prove? We have to prove that angle subtended, that is POQ, that is AOB, is equals to angle POQ. So this we have to prove. To prove this, we have to consider the triangle. So proof, we have to consider the triangle. Consider the triangle AOB. Consider the triangle AOB and triangle POQ. And triangle POQ. So here we can see that is OA. OA is equals to OP. So first thing, I will write this as OA is equals to OP. Okay. Second thing, you can write this as OB is equal to OQ. OB is equals to OQ. OB is equals to OQ. And third thing, you can write this as AB is equals to PQ. So AB is equal to PQ. Okay. So AB is equal to PQ. So again, this is side. Means you can write by SS rule. Means by SSS congruence rule, you can write that triangle AOB is congruent to triangle POQ. If these two are congruent, means by corresponding parts of congruent triangles, you can write as angle AOB is equals to angle POQ. So this is your required proof. Hence, prove. Okay, so first thing what you have to do? First thing you have to do, you have to draw a circle and you have to take the two chords AB and PQ intersect at O, and you have to prove that AOB is equals to POQ. Okay, so prove AOB is equals to angle POQ. So consider the two triangles, triangle AOB and triangle POQ. So if I consider this one, OA is equals to OP, and similarly OB is equals to OQ, and AB is equals to PQ. So again, this will be side, side, side. By side, side rule, we can say triangle AOB is congruent to triangle POQ. For corresponding parts of congruent triangles, angle AOB is equal to angle POQ by, and this is your proof. That is, you can say equal chords of a circle subtend equal angles at the center. Okay, so pause the video to note down this very important theorem. Okay, dear students, now welcome back to the one more question of your polynomials. That is, find P of 0, comma P of 1 and P of 2 if P of y is equal to y square minus y plus 1. So first I will write the given thing, P of y is equal to y square minus y plus 1. So first they took to find P of 0. So first step, that is P of 0 is equal to 0 square minus 0 plus 1. Okay, so 0 square is already 0, 0 minus 0 is already 0, it is 1. So P of 0 is equal to 1. Okay, this is first one. Second one, you are having, if P of y is equals to y square minus y plus 1, that is P of 1 is equal to 1 square minus 1 plus 1. Okay, so 1 square is 1, 1 minus 1 plus 1. So plus 1 minus 1 get cancelled. So P of 1 will be 1. Okay, similarly, third one, we are having P of y is equal to y square minus y plus 1, you need to find the value of P of 2. So P of 2 is equal to 2 square minus 2 plus 1. So 2 square is 4, 4 minus 2 plus 1. So 4 minus 2 will be, obviously it is 2, 2 plus 1, which is equals to 3. So P of 2 is equal to 3. So therefore you can write P of 0 is equal to 1, next P of 1 is equal to 1, and finally P of 2 is equal to 3. Okay, so this is your, if you solve this, you are getting as 3 marks. Okay, so pause the video to note down this example.